Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar. A face rarely seen in 20 years, but a name popular in the streets of Afghanistan. The co-founder and deputy leader of Taliban, Mullah Baradar, is likely to be the next president of Afghanistan. He was not among the Taliban men who strode unopposed into the presidential palace in Kabul on August 15th, but he is credited with getting them there. While Haibatullah Akhundzada is the Taliban's overall leader, Baradar is its political chief and its most public face. Baradar's return to power embodies Afghanistan's incapability to escape the bloody shackles of its past. The story of his adult life is the story of the country's unceasing, pitiless conflict. Born in Uruzgan province in 1968, he fought in the Afghan Mujahideen against the Soviets in the 1980s. After the Russians were driven out in 1989, the country fell into civil war between rival warlords. Baradar set up a madrasa in Kandahar with his former commander and reputed brother-in-law, Muhammad Omar. Together, the two mullahs founded the Taliban, a movement spearheaded by young Islamic scholars dedicated to the religious purification of the country and the creation of an emirate. Fueled by religious fervor and substantial support from the ISI, the Taliban swept to power in 1996. Baradar was a key architect of those victories. During the Taliban's 20-year exile, most Western diplomats viewed him as a potent military leader and a subtle political operator. However, the Obama administration was more fearful of his military expertise. In 2010, the CIA tracked him down and persuaded the ISI to arrest him. However, in 2018, Washington's attitude changed and Donald Trump asked Pakistan to release him so that he could lead negotiations in Qatar. Baradar signed the Doha Agreement in February 2020. The US and Taliban agreement not to fight each other was supposed to be followed by power-sharing talks between the Taliban and Ashraf Ghani's government. However, it is now clear that Baradar and Taliban were waiting only for the Americans to leave so that they could return to power. And they did so swiftly.